IVO, I welcome you to Edim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through business studies from 3, lesson number 2. The topic it is demand and supply. I'm your tutor, Lucy Mudon. Welcome. Let us first look at the lesson objectives. Today we are going to distinguish between the derived demand and the joint demand, and then look at the deriving the demand curve from a demand schedule. So by the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to give the difference between a derived demand and a joint demand. And also, by the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to draw a demand curve from a demand schedule. Let us look at the different types of demand. There are two broad types of demand, namely joint demand and the other one. So we are going to look at the joint demand first. This demand applies to the product that are used or consumed together, the one that we refer to it as the complementary goods. Example, we have car and food. These two, we cannot separate them. They are inseparable. Car and fuel, these two, we use them together. You cannot buy a car and then you fail to buy the fuel. So they go hand in hand. Demand for charge products go the same direction. You are going to get, in case the demand of the car increases, you also, when we talk about the fuel, it will also increase. An increase in demand of one causes an increase in demand of the other one, where the fall of one, the demand of one, it will also result to the fall of the other one. So that is the reason as to why we refer to them as joint demand. They go hand in hand. Number two, we have the derived demand. This occurs when the demand for one product occurs as a result of the demand of another product. A demand for cloth creates the demand for cotton. When the demand for cloth increases, it is going to create room for the demand of cotton also to increase. Therefore, the demand for cotton is derived from the demand for cloth. The more we need the cloth, the more the cotton gets demand. The more we need the second-hand clothes, the more the second-hand clothes are going to get the demand. So in that case now, you see that one commodity is resulting to the increase of the other commodity. That is the reason as to why we are referring to them as derived demand. Other types of demand are competitive demand. These are for cross-substitute, those commodities that can be substituted. You are going to get that for the competitive demand, when one commodity, its demand increases, it results to the decrease of the other commodity, demand of the other commodity. So that is the reason as to why they are referred to as competitive demand. Then we also have the composite demand. These are for the product which have alternative uses. That is the reason as to why we refer to them as the composite demand. If at all the price of one commodity increases, then it results to the consumers going for the alternative. Then we look at the demand schedule. Demand schedule is a table showing the quantity demanded at a particular price. The quantity demanded at a particular price within a particular period of time. Consider the information tabulated below was obtained from Destiny Investment, showing the number of duvets sold at various prices. You have the prices there of the duvets, then the quantity demanded. When it is 30,000, they are selling one quantity. When it is 25, they are selling two. When it is 20, they are selling three. When it is 15,000, they are selling five. When it is 10,000, they are selling eight. When it is 5,000, they are selling 14. And when it is 2,000, they are selling at 20. So that is what we are saying. It is the demand schedule. you have tabulated the demand of that commodity at different prices. That is what is referred to as demand schedule. Demand curve is the graphical representation of a demand schedule. The quantity demanded is plotted. So, again, as the, in the horizontal axis, while the prices of the product is plotted on the y-axis. Now, we are saying that when now we take the tabulated or the demand schedule, tabulated table, and take those values that are provided there, and then we represent it graphically, we are going to get a demand curve. And that is what we are referring to it as a demand curve. How do I get a demand curve? When it comes to drawing a demand curve, we need the horizontal axis and the vertical axis. That is the x-axis and the y-axis. Now, when it comes to the horizontal axis, we plot the quantity demanded. Where in the y-axis, we plot the prices of the product. As you can be able to see, from the schedule that we end for destiny investment, this is the graph, the demand graph we are going to get. That is what you expected. Because when the prices are 30,000, we are setting only one.